Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our concert tonight. I'm Dr. Juliette Singler, and it's a great pleasure to be here with you this evening. Thank you for those of you who were planning to come last week. There was a power outage, and you had to come this week instead. So thanks for your flexibility, and our whole choir has and band has had to be very flexible. So I just thank everyone. It was a little challenging because we lost a rehearsal, and we had to do all the rehearsing before our concert tonight. But we are hoping that you will be blessed by this music. This first song that we're going to perform is from a poem that I wrote several years ago, and I just want to read the words to you because it goes by a little fast when we sing it. But it says, Palo Verde, beautiful tree of knowledge. Palo Verde, I think you are that tree. Palo Verde, you spring up everywhere. You frequently cross borders. You never seem to have a care and no regard for order. Your leaves arrive first on the scene. They always have a lot to say. Your bark is $100 green. Your yellow blossoms shout today. You survive when life is harsh and never bow to drought or heat. You quench your thirst from monsoon's marsh. You give shelter to the weak. If knowledge knows no boundaries, if learning brings opportunity, if education protects and frees, I think you are that tree, Palo Verde. Musical friends to come on stage. Kayleen Pecora, who is our elementary music instructor in the district, such a great friend and colleague, and now a faculty member here at Palo Verde College. And Lynn Dvorkin, many of you know Lynn because she used to be a music director here in town of the Bell Choir. And also, Car Tenos, who will be on hand drum. Now, the youth choir just started about 5 years ago, and it was an outgrowth of the adult choir. The people who were interested in singing in town decided to form a club at the college, And so as an outreach of the club, they decided they wanted to bring music to the youth of the area. So we started the Palo Verde Youth Choir, and it has just been a delight to work with these young people. I think last semester was our best enrollment. We had 22, wasn't it, Kathy, that we had turn out for the youth choir last fall. Say, it's Kayleen, it's so great to have you as a colleague and now a faculty member at Palo Verde College. And you'll get to see more from Kayleen at the end. She'll be conducting our almost final number. We're going to hear from some special friends of mine right now, and this is a band that has become iconic in Blythe over the last few years. They started over at Joyce Pacifico's music store on Hobson Way and gelled, and then moved up here to campus. And so for the last 5 years, they've been leading a jam session on Monday nights. It's the Still Kicking Band. And let me introduce the members to you. Lead singer and guitar is Rick Hewitt in the middle there. And then on bass, we have Joel Gordon on the end. In the middle there, we've got John Krebs on guitar and vocals and harmonica. And then Joyce Pacifico on percussion. Let's hear it for Still Kicking Band.
Mississippi saxophone. From the heat of
That I've made along the line here in my 9 years at Palo College. Did you hear that I'm retiring? Yes. Yes, I'm retiring this year, and it has been such a pleasure because you have blessed me richly here in Blythe, California. I tell you, there's so many different little things that have come up with, you know, getting the theater ready, running the theater, and do you know that we use volunteers in the theater here? I just want to point that out because we need more of you to volunteer here in the theater. We've got Sean Rand on lights up there. He's one of our firefighters. And Matt Fire on our sound, making us sound beautiful tonight. Actually, Camille is our box office manager outside there, and Kim Ju is helping out with the house management. So yeah, so many different things come up. I'll tell you an example. Because you wouldn't believe this, but the person that probably knows most about the lighting system in town is one of the dance dads. Because he's been doing the lighting for the dance shows for like 15 years. And so I went up in the light booth to look at something on stage before the concert about a month ago, maybe a month and a half ago, and I noticed that some of the programming was gone. Some of the programming I rely on for my concerts. And so I mentioned it to him, and I said, you know, I might have to call on you, just wait, because I'm gonna go back up there and see what's what. And you know what, the next time I saw him, he said, hey, I went back up there and rebooted the whole system. So guess who it was? AJ Slagan. Thank you, AJ. I really appreciate all of those little favors that I've been able to call in over the years. One of the groups that I've met along the way is the Ballet Folklorico Colores de Aztlan, and they are led by Amnesty Figueroa Garnica. And you know what? Her mother started this dance group 52 years ago here in Blythe. So we collaborated with them a little bit last year, and we're very pleased to be able to bring them to your stage again today for a performance of De Colores.
Thank you.
we go. Well, since I'm retiring, boy, I'm really gonna miss you guys, all of you, and this beautiful, beautiful place. That's why I entitled this program, This Beautiful Land, because I love driving. I live over by the golf course, so I love driving down here to Palo Verde College and into town and seeing the beautiful fields that we have. And even better than that is the beautiful people that I've met while I've been here. So we thought this would be a great time to call all the people that have been involved with the choir over the years up to the stage to sing with us a song we sing just about every semester, Cantar by Jay Althaus. So come on up, those of you who have sung with the choir in the past, we've got music for you. Come on up on the ramp there. Yes, here we go. Come stand with the choir, and oh, it's great to have you all with us. This is gonna be fun. Singing that's in mostly Spanish, but some English. It says, sing a beautiful song. Singing with us today. That's wonderful. We're going to do Sing Cielito Lindo next. So, yeah. So thank you. Travis on trumpet, Travis Joslin, and Marcus. We're going to pray grupo Colores de Aztlán back again with us to sing Cielito Lindo, to dance for Cielito Lindo. This year on stage, Travis Joslin. Come on stage. So Travis will be leaving us, unfortunately, this year. And where are you going next?
I'm going to be going to Greenville, California to attend College of the Redwoods.
Travis is a wonderful musician who came here from the high school band, and he was so kind, he came and sang with us as well, and last year he did many caroling gigs. We would dress up at Christmas time, we like to dress up as Dickens carolers, and he came with us on some of those gigs and played with us, and it was great to have him here. Now this year he's gotten a little busier, he's got a job, I hate jobs, darn it. But he still comes around and he wants to play something for you, and of course we heard him play in Cantar as well. And so let's hear it for Travis Joslin, who's going to be playing for you. Beso de mucho.
Thank you.
this with your graduation robe. This is the color of music is purple. So to honor your participation with us in music, thank you so much for being with us, and please wear this with pride.
First of all, I'd like to thank Dr. Singler for giving me the opportunity to play for y'all. It's been a pleasure working with Dr. Singler. I've been working with her since my senior year of high school. It was always great to play with the choir, always great to have another opportunity to play my instrument. And that opportunity is being presented to you all tonight. So as you know, Dr. Singler's leaving us. And in order to continue music, Kaylee Picoro will be taking up the torch to lead the band for BBC. And when it comes to playing an instrument, the two things you need are an instrument, of course, and you also need a ring of support. And with the BBC Pep Band, you are offered both at no cost. If you've played, if you have any interest in playing, I really recommend that you go talk to Kayleen, and maybe you check it out on BBC registration. They're looking for more people, and I would love to see the music program continue. Thank you all for listening to me tonight. I hope you enjoyed the song Mucho.
Yes, many people don't know, but we just this year were given a grant that allowed us to buy band instruments for the college. So we had our first band here at the college this year, and I really would love to see it grow. That's what I desire most when I retire, is that music should continue and grow and flourish here at Palo Verde and also in Blythe in general. So my colleague Brian Tiebo, who remembers Brian, always wore bow ties. He was a wonderful musician as well, a violinist, and he and I started this endowment fund, and it's almost reached its maturity. It's at about 11,700, and it has to go up to 15,000 when it arrives there. Then we can draw interest off of that amount and award scholarships. So that's what we're hoping to do in part tonight, is to raise some money for that. So I don't know if you've already gotten a ticket for the drawing, but if you haven't already, you still have the opportunity to run out. I know Allie will help you. We've got $20 tickets available for our drawing, and tonight someone is going to go home $500 richer, and then the money that we collect from the concert and the drawing, anything that exceeds our concert expenses, we'll go over towards that endowment fund, and hopefully we'll begin making scholarship awards next spring. I'm going to ask the youth choir to come downstage and sing something. This is from the point of view of Travis Joslin, what he would like to say to you. The song, many of you know this song, it's entitled, "You're Gonna Miss Me When I'm Gone." And here to help us is Aletea Vidal on helping out with the rhythm. Aletea was in the youth choir just last semester, and she matriculated to the adult choir this semester.
Take you for the long way round to a bottle of whiskey.
for our soloists, it was Daisy Luth and then Carl Roseberry, and then it was Evie Rand and then Luna Kouachon. Let's hear for our soloists. Well, this is another treat, is that I have these choir members who keep returning semester after semester, like Miss Kathy Jensen. She has been my right-hand woman in getting the youth choir up and rolling. I remember the early days when we first founded the youth choir. We were at the rec center downtown, and she and Mary Powers helped me to offer some classes to youth, and then we started thinking, you know what, we should form a youth choir. And so my choir members continually come to me and they say, you know what, I met a child in the community that really should come and sing with you. They're really extraordinary. And that's just what happened with this family. So you see before you Luna Kouachon, and her sister is going to join her out here, Vera, and also her brother, Lucas Malik. They're a family, and sometimes they make music together, so I thought it would be wonderful to ask them to make music together tonight on our stage. So I let them choose any song that they wanted to choose, as long as it was within our theme of this beautiful land, and they chose What a Wonderful World. So we're going to make a few adjustments here and get our guitars ready and our amps ready, so be patient for a second while we get everything adjusted. Guitarist in and of itself, so I knew we were going to be doing this number by Paul McCartney, Blackbird. I'm sure you've heard of it. And so I said, Lucas, do you think you could play that? And he goes, well, it's the first song I ever learned on guitar, so I guess so. So that was lucky for us. I'm going to ask the adult choir to come back on stage. And this is another great surprise, is that as I've been doing things in the community for now 9 years, sometimes we have different projects that we work on, and one that we worked on in the past, you're going to see it in the highlights section of your program, was we did a performance of The Pirates of Penzance, and we needed dancers for that. So I called up one of the dance studios in town, and I found a wonderful friend in Kiva Hollywood who choreographed some dancers for that, and we did it twice with her choreography. And I think both times was with this wonderful, talented dancer who's now in our adult choir, Alitea Vidal. So she and her friend Lola choreographed a dance to Blackbird. And we would like to present it for you now. To a concert at a park, and they had some different bands playing, and then they had this one singer performing. I thought, man, that guy has a terrific voice, and we became fast friends. And so he sung a couple of concerts with us, and I asked him if he would come and sing this concert and if we could do a little something for him, because I am so pleased to tell you that he auditioned for the Air Force Big Band of the West and was given a placement. And so he'll be an enlisted man this fall. And so everybody welcome with me, Sam Saxton. you to be going in the Air Force. It's going to mean so much to see that you can broaden the influence that you have. You've already made such an impression on all of us here and in Arizona, but now you'll have an even wider palette to paint.
Well, I would just encourage you kids, you know, on career day at school, I never knew that you could be a vocalist for the Air Force. So, you can be a vocalist, you can be a guitar player, you can be a trombone player, you can be a tuba player. If you play an instrument, get really good and join the Air Force, or any armed forces for that matter, and play music for our country.
Awesome. Sarah's going to sing the last number with us, but before we get there, we wanted to honor some of our vets, and so I'm going to ask our veterans to come up on stage. Oh, I think I'm taking everything out of order. We have to do the drawing first. Will you help me do the drawing, Sam? All right, we want to see who's going to win $500 first, so let us do the drawing. Who's going to bring the, okay, yes. The drawing tabs are coming up. Allie, can you bring those up for us? It's coming. Oh, right over here. Yes. And if you would be so kind, shake it up really good. Sam, don't look in the box, but we're gonna have you. He doesn't know everyone here, so he's gonna do the picking. So it can be fair and impartial.
Yeah, they didn't. I don't think they got mixed up very good. All right.
Gwen Crawford.
Oh, Gwen. You don't have to be here tonight, and Gwen is not here tonight. She is one of my choir members who, she had another family obligation she could not change for tonight, so. She's going to be excited to find out that she won, though, for sure. I'll keep that. Let's hear it for Gwen. We're going to call the Palo Verde High School Band on stage. I went to their concert just last week, and they sounded terrific. So I asked them if they would play a number. And I believe what they're going to play is called Cabo Rico, correct? Yes. Thank you. director. Jose, it's great to have you as a colleague, and thanks for all your support over the years. Sam, help me with something. We're going to bring some veterans up to, because he's going to be a veteran soon. And so we thought, since it's Memorial Weekend, we should honor our veterans. So I believe I have a former choir member, John Hoagie, who's going to help us with this. And I'll call John up to the stage. John served in the Army. And guess what? Did you know that my dad was a World War II veteran, and he served in the Army as well. He was in the Corps of Engineers. And so we still have the letters that he wrote back to my mom while he was serving in the war. Very, very tender, very sweet. And so I want to thank everyone who has served, and it's an amazing thing to do. And so we told Sam that we would prepare a salute that features all of the songs of the different branches of service in it, which we'll perform with the high school band in just a moment. But first, we wanted to do a little bit of a color guard for you. Carl, would you bring the stand out for us?
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. My name is John Hoagie, the Vice Commander of the local VFW. This is Mr. Vincent Armadetta, the Commander of the local VFW. We'd like to make a real quick request. Could the house lights be brought up at all? Because the next request isn't going to make much sense if it's dark. Do we have any veterans in the room, A, and B, would they please stand? If you would please remain standing, and would those of you in the audience who can stand also stand? That always gets a giggle, I understand. I think you know what's coming next. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you very much. And remember this coming Monday, Memorial Day, thank a veteran if you can.
Thank you, John. Thank you. And we would like to, yes. Thank you for your service. We would like to perform a medley of songs from the different branches of service, and Sam's gonna help me out with this a little bit. So if your branch of the service comes up, then we want you to clap for that branch of the service as it comes up. Stand as your service song is sung. And then everybody has in their program the songs, and you know some of them. I hope you know them anyway. And so if you would love to sing along with us, then please do sing along with us.
Thank you.
Together here on one stage. It's wonderful to have you here. And Sam, now we're going to ask you to sing with us. This is kind of a return. Sam was raised in Louisiana, you have to understand. So getting to sing in the big band of the West, where his base will be Texas probably, right?
San Antonio. Yeah.
San Antonio. This is a homecoming of sorts for him.
Yeah, and basically 7 hours away from home, so that puts me a little closer to Louisiana and the same humidity, so.
Well, you can take that humidity with you.
Yeah.
We're gonna ask Sam to sing this last song with us. It's called Homeward Bound. Great to see you all. Hope to see you there in just a few minutes. Bye.